Hey everyone, I've been off the grid a little bit the past couple of weeks. There's been some personal things going on, and I obviously was hitting Mirror's Edge Catalyst pretty hard. I was going to do a video about that, I was going to do a first impressions, and then I was going to do a post-game sum-up, but I'm not really feeling it, so I'm not going there. What I do want to talk about is a web series I've just finished, which is called Marble Hornets. Tomorrow is actually the 7th anniversary of its first video. And there's probably some people watching this who have seen it before and they're just like, Jesus, Ryan, why is it taking you so long to get around to it? But this is the way things go. I don't watch a lot of TV, you know, I've not seen things like Breaking Bad or Game of Thrones, but I do spend a lot of time sort of hunting out lesser known stuff online. I see a lot of like really obscure films on Vimeo and YouTube and stuff. And I really love creepypastas and things like that, so I catch a lot of narrations and dramatisations and just reading those. Marble Hornets came across my path because of those. It's a horror series based around the Slenderman mythology. And it's found footage. And I can quite confidently say it's one of the greatest works of horror fiction I've ever come across. I know I have this gift for hyperbole, but it is an astonishing work. And that has to be one of the many reasons why to date it currently has 87 million views on YouTube. So say, yeah, it started back in 2009 and it is a found footage series. It basically focuses on a small cast of characters who were involved in a student film called Marble Hornets. You don't really get an idea about what Marble Hornets was supposed to be about. But it, from what footage of it you do see, it looks like a typical student romance film. You know, those of us who've studied filmmaking, it's the sort of thing, you know, we tried to make at some point. The director and writer of it is a guy called Alex, and at the start of the series, he basically becomes a recluse. He almost completely disappears, and he leaves the initial footage from Marble Hornets with one of the crew members, Jay, who, trying to figure out why there's been this sudden turn in Alex's behaviour, starts going through the footage tape by tape. And these are the entries which ended up being uploaded to the YouTube channel. There's 87 entries in total. But there are little add-ons and sidelines as well. So it means in total Marble Hornets, the series has about 92 episodes. The thing about found footage films and everything else is that it's difficult to justify why characters would carry on filming while they're being hunted by monsters or serial killers or whatever. You know, why would they pick it up if they've been knocked over and they're trying to run away from something? Marble Hornets gets around this through several ways. The first one obviously being the fact that it's about filmmakers. The second is that as things deteriorate throughout the series, as the story progresses, the characters who are making the films become increasingly paranoid and they start setting up multiple cameras in their bedrooms and around their houses. It's a very seamless way of meshing it all together. And the other thing that Marble Hornets does really well is play around with the chronology of events. So early on in the series, a lot of it is a straightforward Jay going through Alex's tapes one by one. So entry one is obviously, you know, one of the first tapes he was given, and he goes on. And then each episode, whoever is presenting the tapes, whoever has edited and uploaded the entries, they add their own little text summations and just things about what they think about what's going on and, you know, rhetorical questions about the events and things like that. Around about the sort of, as you go into the 20s, more tapes start getting found or given to people. And they actually fill in gaps or even confuse certain things which had happened in previous entries, like earlier in the series. And this sort of thing keeps happening throughout. Characters will get into conflicts over certain things that have been uncovered. I'm trying not to go too much into the story. There's just several characters. There's Alex, the original filmmaker. There's Jay. There's a couple of actors, Brian and Tim. There's a girl called Jessica. There's another girl you don't really see called Amy. I think she's only in one entry, and that's in sort of a very hurried, scary episode. And there's also some masked figures who are more or less just identified as To the Ark. Now, To the Ark is also a companion series for Marble Hornets. I've not actually watched it yet because, as I say, I've only just finished watching the main series itself. From what I can tell, they are much more abstract and surreal. And they are basically answers of a kind to the events in Marble Hornets. They're also, you know, veiled threats. They're there to confuse and disorientate Jay. Jay's obviously the initial protagonist, but then as things go on, you know, other characters do take up the mantle. They might only do it briefly before Jay becomes the focus again, and later on it sort of shifts towards Tim. And so there is the angle of Slenderman, who many of you probably know. Obviously, he first famously appeared on 4chan, and he's gone into sort of popular culture, and he's become very much an urban legend in his own right. In terms of the chronology, like I mentioned before, there is another aspect to Marble Hornets which affects a lot of the characters. There's sort of like lacuna in their memories. They lose whole stretches of time. They find themselves displaced from, say, where they sort of were driving to, and then suddenly find themselves in a completely different location. It's just astonishingly well constructed. It's meticulously designed. The execution of it is just superb. Roger Ebert actually was a huge fan of the series, and obviously, you know, Roger Ebert, a guy who made his career from primarily focusing on, you know, mainstream releases. I can't recommend this series enough. There apparently is a new series on a different channel called Clear Lakes 44, which has come out. There was a film released last year, apparently, which I'm going to check out probably later today, which, again, it kind of has the vibe of what happened with the Blair Witch Project with the sequel, Book of Shadows. It's basically like a studio has jumped on it, and then, from what I can tell, the results sound like they're mixed, but I'm going to go in with an open mind. Make time for Marble Hornets. As I say, there is, as far as I'm aware, there isn't an episode which goes over 15 minutes. There are super edits. I've seen one that's like 8.5 hours long on YouTube. It's probably best to watch it how it was initially intended, which is in bite-sized chunks. Because obviously the videos were uploaded over weeks and months. And that was obviously part of the main effect of it, is the fact that I imagine when it was first released, people were going onto discussion boards and discussing it. You know, there's no credits or anything to Marble Hornets. You know, people would have interacted with it. You know, possibly asking their own questions. There are other videos out there where people discuss the meaning and the symbolism of it. You owe it to yourself to see Marble Hornets. And I'm very interested to see what people think. So I'm going to drop links in this video to obviously the channel itself and some of the things around it. But drop me a comment on my channel, because I really would love to talk to someone about this. And so, see you later.